was here, again. Zane said the manuscript of Return was the key to escaping. I had to get it before Scratch did.
Had I chosen to pursue the cult, or had they chosen me for some unknowable purpose? To be a demon, to sort the clues based on my interpretation, to change that which I observed. It was all a play. Shadows on the wall of a cave, an echo of the true events that happened somewhere else. Was I there to watch the shadows, or was I a shadow too? In a performance set up for someone else. Alan Wake. Darkness is coming. I arrive.
The dark place wouldn't let me go that way.
Thank you.
crash was closing in, gaining control. I couldn't let him escape the dark place. I had to keep him from Alice. Alice had turned the bathroom into a dark room.
For months after Alan died, I didn't leave the apartment. I was flattened by the confusion, the shock, the guilt, fear.
I needed to get inside the manuscript. Alice's work had consumed the apartment. Her whole life.
Mary Taylor started visiting. He even cooked me meals. I couldn't stand the guy when I first met him, but he's a better friend than I gave him credit for. One morning, I saw a deer soar past my bedroom window. It was a balloon of some cartoon animal. And I looked out at the street below, and I saw a little girl crying. Like losing that balloon had just ended her whole world. It was the perfect image. The horror of caring. And that's when I got myself out of bed. And I picked up my camera. For months. Something in the dark. Something I needed to see, to show. The more more shadows I photographed and filmed, the more I felt like I was on the verge of a breakthrough. I submerged myself in it. I only went out at night. My search became obsessive, but I still had no idea what I was looking for. In the shadows. Fear of the dark is really just fear of what could be, that vast, paralyzing ocean. But photography can freeze reality in a snapshot, put a cage around the infinite and capture it. I need to prove those faces are really there.
Manuscript of a novel. Return. A horror story about the dark presence escaping from the dark place, taking over Bright Falls. I couldn't remember writing it. I had not written it. I would never write this. I knew who had. Scratch, a monster with my face. If this story came true, Scratch would get out, people would die. Destroying the manuscript, it wouldn't stop it from happening. I would have to fix it, edit it. I could not change the genre of the story. I'd have to work within the constraints set by Scratch. I needed someone in the story to fight the darkness. Saga Anderson. I kept seeing her in my visions. She was already in Bright Falls, already involved, but she was not in Return. Not yet. I'd write her in, try to stop Scratch within the limits of the horror story. It was almost impossible. It was taking too long. I had not reached the end. Scratch stopped me before I could finish my edits to the manuscript. The memory of my edits was already fading. Terrible things would happen if the manuscript came true. Scratch was there, at Parliament Tower, undoing my work. He could use the story to escape. He could go after Alice. Zane had said we worked on Return together. That was a lie. Scratch wrote Return. I would pay Zane another visit. He had guided me to two murder sites. I needed a new one to get back to Parliament Tower. A new draft of initiation. I needed a new draft of the story. One that would get me a... I needed a new draft of the story. It could not be opened on the side.
I don't have time for this, so let's get it over with. Tell me, was this all fake? A show?
No one said otherwise, Mr. Wake. It was to indulge you, but we can stop pretending now.
Masks come off.
Oh, I wouldn't go that far. I don't even think you know who's under your mask, but you know how to make things difficult for yourself. All these rules, endless, convoluted loops you insist on going through. You are so lucky, you know. There are so many people helping you. Armies of people. Myself. Your wife.
Alice. I need to get to her. She's in danger.
She is. Because of you. And so is someone important to me, someone you pulled into this. You keep opening doors, peeking in, reaching through to get what you want, and that puts you in my path.
I don't know what you're talking about. I have to go now.
Maybe you will make it through this time. This has gone on long enough. This and our Night Springs, it was a nice distraction.
It's time someone gave me a straight answer here.
The next time we meet, the circumstances will be very different. And you would do well to return the favor by playing your part. Or stay out of my way, Mr. Wake.
Whatever you say.
Dor, Zane, the masks were finally coming off. Was it a sign I was closer to escaping? I had no time to waste.
This isn't your story.
Alan Wake.
Wake. Wake. Darkness inside. Wake. Wake.
The door was locked.
At the end of the tunnel. If you come in last, you won't be happy.
Wake!
Jumalauta, that held you close, Tom. Ei muuttako onward, said the granny in the snow. When the panic is biggest, the help is also near.
Dor didn't seem happy to see me this time.
Hearing the master is the root of wisdom. But don't let the game get you down. He's playing his role. Maybe put him in your films, Tom, like you have put me. Sehän olisik.
What films?
I'm a fan of your masterworks. There is Tom the Poet, my favorite. And Yöten Yö is the most famous one, of course. And is it true what I hear? That it's coming back to cinemas soon? Is there a bottom to this rumor?
I need to get back to my apartment. Can you help me?
Well, plan is half done. You asked me to make sure you won't forget the... Mikä se valokuva oli? The light pictures. The photos you artist wife took. They are waiting in the shoebox in the basement. What you leave behind, you find in front of you.
Okay. Thanks, Adi. I couldn't get in. I was missing something.
Wake. 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 I need the words. Wake. Wake. This story will kill you.
These were Alice's photos. I recognized the style. One showed the clicker sinking into darkness. The other showed a light in the shape of a bullet. They were important, even if I didn't know what to do with them yet. To get to Parliament Tower, I needed to find a murder site. Zane would know where to find one.
Oh.
messy maze of blood trails I was chasing the cult through, I ran into the filmmaker, Thomas Zane, an esoteric bohemian with a hard-on for acts of cruelty performed in the name of occult nonsense. A director wants to control every aspect of the world in their films. Is a cult leader any different? Was Zane just another alias for Scratch? There was a rumor that Wake and Zane had been working on something together. I was going to get the truth out of Zane with whatever means necessary.
Wake. Stop using the word. Wake. Those are the words.
Zane's room, 665, was upstairs. The elevator would take me there. Something told me Zane wouldn't be happy to see me this time.
I'm in control now. The second you try anything, I will shoot you in the head! Scratch wrote return, not me. You're a fucking liar!
You'd given up. You stopped writing. You said it was too dangerous, that we didn't deserve to get out. And then he showed up. Scratch. He promised to write. To get me the hell out of here. He was magnificent. Visionary. I mean, it was art. But then, when it finished, it took return and left me behind.
It's still here, and so is he.
I know I fucked up. But you can still catch him before he gets out, before he gets to your wife. You get to him. Don't hesitate. Kill the bastard for what he did to us. There's a murder site in my cinema, where my film Nightless Night is playing.
I told you not to try anything!
Thousands have gone missing, beyond the labyrinth of me. When you're lost in your own company. And cut! Oh. Now that is drama.
I had a million questions about Zane, but I had more pressing concerns. I had to find the movie theater Poet Cinema. The next murder site was there. Zane had created the film in tandem with Return to escape the dark place. I could see the searchlight beams of the movie theater on the far side of the plaza.
Thank you.
It could not be opened on the side. Door wouldn't open.
inside this net.
The theater appeared to be closed. Maybe the ticket could still get me in.
Something kept me going. A broken man. No hope, no prospects, no love. Too stubborn to die. Like a cockroach with a misguided sense of honor and justice in a city where there can never be justice.
Thank you.
us in his image. Just like us, he is an uncaring, cruel son of a bitch. Having made it in heaven, he doesn't want us there, dirtying up all that nice white upholstery. And he doesn't want to reach down to help us. He gets his kicks just binge-watching us struggling, hurting, killing, dying, screwing it up again and again. Lazily stirring it up when things threaten to get too placid. This city is only here to satisfy his sick, voyeuristic pleasure.
Enjoy the film, sir.
The cinema lobby was a gateway to other realities on the silver screen. I could set a scene here. Did I stop writing at some point? I can't stop. There's too much at stake. The main event was the murder. I had to find my way to it. I was missing something.
He's looking for the cult.
I felt like I'd been on this case looking for the cult of the word for a lifetime or more. The only case I'd ever been on. They would surface from the dark with their depraved acts of violence and fade back into the night, leaving behind bloody crime scenes and clues heavy with obscure meanings that led nowhere. Arriving at the cinema, I felt a monumental, terrifying revelation trembling before me, ready to open its jaws and swallow me whole.
This place had significance to the cult. There was something to use there. First step toward the murder site. I was making progress. Someone had barricaded themselves in the room.
Do you a lot of good to talk, buddy.
was an initiation ceremony. Or so we made our new members believe. Two of New York's finest. They had performed endless favors to earn their place among us. We had something special waiting for them. And something very special for you, Alex Casey.
Who's your leader? Alan Wake? Hmm? Scratch? Zane? Give me a name!
You will meet him soon enough.
There was no end to the corruption. It fit the genre, so I'd use it. The scene here had changed.
The urban legends circling Thomas Zane were a bottomless rabbit hole. I'd done some digging. To film freaks, he was a mythic auteur in the art house cinema. A rising star coming to America from Finland. But he only created one film. Tom the Poet, before he went missing, mirroring the vanishing of the main character in the movie, played by himself. The biggest mystery was around his lost film, an early work made in Finland, Nightless Night, rumored to have mystic properties. Some claimed it was a snuff film, that the ritual murder in the film was an actual murder. There were no known surviving copies, but the cult chased it as if it were their unholy grail, just like Wake's books were.
It changed. Cops had gotten their 15 minutes of fame with the cult, and it had been a scream. They were the murder victims. I had to find a way into the projection booth somehow. It was locked from the other side.
And hoods, pretending to be a secret society.
Maybe it is you who's playing a role, Mr. Casey. A role carefully laid out for you. A puppet blindly performing the ritual steps for the glory of the cult. Huh?
What the fuck have you been smoking?
Nightless Night. A clip of the lost film survived. You will see, Mr. Casey. In the Nightless Night, you will finally see.
Nightless Night was Zane's film. It played a role in his story.
Wake. This is the start.
in the clip holding my lamp. Was he playing me in his film? Zane's lamp on the screen had no light. I could transfer the light in my lamp to his. The light of the lamp shone out of the screen and revealed the door. I was back out into the night. The seedy alley away from prying eyes was a good scene for dark deeds. I needed to find the answer on the plot board. Changes shape the world around me. The police car felt important to the story.
You don't think they're gonna want us to, like, cut off a finger or something for this initiation, do you?
Nah. I'm sure we'll just chant some ceremonial stuff. Nothing to it.
Well, it's about time. We paid our dues. made plenty of their problems disappear. Dumped all those nobodies down that chute.
What we did or didn't do, it's all behind us now. We're going straight to the top, partner.
Yeah, like we died and went to heaven.
I was close to finding the solution. Someone had fallen to their death from the rooftop. In the city trapped in eternal night, they watch the film where the night never arrives, where the night hides in your mind. The plot changed the details of the world. straight to the top. The dirty cops looked down at the city. Their city. They had committed repulsive deeds to get there. They told themselves it was worth it. It could not be opened on the side. Writing was affecting reality.
Don't you fucking move, or I'll blow you away.
You got me, Mr. Casey. I'm all yours. Go ahead. Ask that burning question in your mind.
How did you do it? How did you get me into that film clip without my remembering it? Talk to me, damn it!
You've seen the film? Good, good. Now you're ready to meet the Grandmaster. He's waiting for you in the projection booth where everything will be revealed, where he will project a new reality onto this one. And now, Mr. Casey, I've played my part to the end.
No, no, no! Crazy bastard! Why'd he jump?
The projection booth. Was that where I'd find the murder site?